Hey guys, this is Ben with FCP. Today we're working on a 1996 Volvo 850 Turbo. We're going to be replacing the timing belt, serpentine belt, and water pump. If you're replacing the water pump, the first step you want to do is drain the coolant from the car using the petcock on the radiator. There's a link in the description of this video that you can follow. After that, pull the coolant reservoir and disconnect the electrical connector. Flop that over the side. And using a 12 millimeter socket, remove the outside timing cover. Lift the cover up and set that aside. Using a serpentine belt tool, release the tensioner and remove the belt. Being careful not to pinch your fingers. As you can see, this belt is fairly cracked and is in need of a replacement. With the wheel off the car, you want to remove the plastic nut that holds the panel to the fender. Fold that up out of the way, and you can clamp down with a pair of small vice grips. With a 30 millimeter socket, you want to turn the motor over until the timing marks line up with the notches on the timing belt cover. As you can see here. Next, I like to insert my cam lock tool. If you don't have one, that's okay. You don't need it. It just makes the job a little easier. You also want to make sure that the crank pulley is lined up with the notch on the oil pump. There's a small tick in the crank pulley that you can see. And again, line that with the oil pump notch. Using a T25 Torx bit, remove your upper fuel line bracket. Set that aside. Once that's out of the way, you can move your fuel lines over. Remove the spark plug cover bolts. Lift up the upper cover and remove it. Loosen the lower tensioner bolt using a 12 millimeter socket. And remove the top bolt. Next, pivot the tensioner off of the idler to relieve pressure and remove the lower bolt. And remove the tensioner. When I pivoted the tensioner off of the idler pulley, what I was doing was relieving the tension of the piston on the idler. By doing that, you remove all the stress that is then put on this bolt, and you won't stress it and possibly shear it or damage the threads. So again, it's very important. You loosen the lower one, remove the top bolt, and then swing the tensioner to the side off of the idler, and then it is safe to pull the bolt out. Next, using a 10 millimeter wrench, remove the lower timing belt shield. Remove the lower and the upper bolts, and remove the shield. Next, pull the belt off the water pump and tensioner pulleys, as well as the cam gears. Pull it out through the bottom. Using a Torx T45 bit, remove the tensioner idler. Next, remove the timing belt idler pulley using a 12 millimeter socket. Next, start removing the 10 millimeter bolts for the water pump. You want to make sure you have a catch pan underneath the engine to catch any residual coolant that might come out when you remove the water pump. As you can see, the water pump spins very freely, and I could feel a little bit of slop in the bearing, so it was a good thing we went to change this. Remove any old bits of gasket that are remaining. After you've cleaned the mating surface up, it's time to install the new water pump. Using a HEPU water pump, really good quality aftermarket unit that I've had great success with. Slide the gasket over the locating dowels. All of the bolts come with Loctite. Start reinstalling all of the bolts. Once all the water pump bolts are snugged down, you want to torque them evenly to 15 foot-pounds of torque. You want to go in a zigzag pattern, similar to how you torque wheels. Once the water pump is properly torqued, you can start installing the tensioners and idler pulleys. First, we'll install our GMB timing belt idler pulley. Next, we'll install our INA tensioner idler. After the idler is installed, install the tensioner. We're using Continental serpentine belts as well as a timing belt. the timing belt down around the camshaft's and tensioner. As well as the water pump. Next, rotating the crank, I've removed the slack from the belt. Replace the upper timing cover. Once you've verified the timing is still in the correct position, you can pull the pin on the tensioner. If you used a timing lock, make sure you remove it before you start the engine or rotate it. And then rotate the engine over twice completely to make sure that you've retained proper timing. And make sure the crank is lined up with the oil pump as well. Replace the lower timing belt plate. Make sure to replace the plastic clip onto the tensioner. Replace the outside timing cover. As well as the bolt. Replace the upper timing belt bolts. As well as a fuel line bracket. Using your serpentine belt tensioner tool, release tension and slide the belt over the idler. Inspect the belt to make sure that it sits inside all the pulleys and you're all set. Plug the reservoir back in, slide it over the clamp, and the spark plug cover bolts. Remove your vice grips and reattach the fender liner to the body. As your last steps, if you did a water pump, remember to fill up your coolant system. If you have any questions about that, you can reference the link in the description of this video. Fill out your timing belt sticker with the mileage and date that you did the timing belt. If you have any questions, call FCP, and thanks for watching.